DJ's Boo Breakfast.
Good morning. Good morning, Morena! Welcome to the DJ's Boo Breakfast!
Is Faith Alive your first single? And no. Why did you want to get into music?
Faith Alive, my first commercial single. I used to release like music underground, you know, in the...
Hey, when I'm gonna understand, why didn't you say that you sing?
But...
You sing? I don't know that you sing.
No, I sing. I do a note or two.
So people hide certain talents.
No, look, I just...
And then they just look, them.
I just didn't know. I just was waiting for that one song to just really like roll with. I was trying to find my style, so I found my style, and here I am.
And what do you call your style, though?
Squireism, I don't know.
but have you always had a plan that you're going to do television, and then at some point you're going to release music, or you were like, when it happens, it'll happen?
Television was a mistake. It wasn't a mistake, it happened, DJ. Music was always the journey, and the problem with music was that I just didn't know what how I wanted to do it. I knew I wanted to sing. I don't know what, how. So I was like, well, let me take my time. Then television kind of happened, but me being me, I just had to like, I really put like 90% in. I really just like, I think I'm one of those people who I like the golden horn, you know. I like, you know, doing something and just being like really hard at it. Performing arts was always the way I wanted to go. I mean, it's almost like it was, even when I wasn't chasing it, it was chasing me.
Yeah.
I mean, I started working when I was 5. I've been working my whole life.
I don't know, man. I'm 5, so keep it a taxi and so I'm 17.
I'm sure I'm going to keep it a taxi. But like, for me, it was just like, just do you and just keep going. So now doing music this is my milestone. And now it's only up and up from here.
But how's the journey been? Because I mean, to break into a certain scene takes quite some time. I actually started on television presenting. I posted something, a video of myself and Zola back in the day. So I started on TV, right?
Yeah.
The music came out.
It was, man, you know, it was difficult. But here's the thing about music is that music, if you thought you had cojones, you had that thing. You don't have that thing until you have to engage with music, especially if you have to engage in music with as an independent artist who has to deal with, you know, all the spheres of a musician, you know, the marketing, the distribution,
Inkinto.
I mean, you Melu is strong. You're going to fight you never thought you're gonna fight. You have to. If you are not a fighting person, I don't think you should be an independent artist. You can still be a musician, just get someone to fight for you. Just know that when the cake comes, it's that person's gonna have to take their cut for all that fighting.
But why go musician? Why go independent though?
Because I just want to own my stuff.
Okay.
I just, you know, for me, yes, entertainment was always part of the plan, but the business of entertainment was always part of the plan as well. I mean, it's cool to like be doing things and be signed and stuff, and it was, and it's gonna get tempting because, especially if you got a good product, because then I had all sorts of people wanting to sign me, all sorts of record labels, and I just didn't want to. I really, if you're going to stick to something, then do it.
Wouldn't it be prudent to get a team?
I do have a team.
You do have a team. Okay,
yeah.
Cool.
Oh, so there are other,
because the way he's speaking, it's as if he's doing everything on his own.
Yeah.
I hate to think that you're doing that, because then the burden on you as an individual is
No, but no, here's the thing. The best entertainers are the ones that have, the most sustained entertainers are the ones that were able to lead their career. So you can't, I mean, if you look at entertainers, let's say people that everyone knows, like if we look at Beyonce has been trained into becoming who she is today from when she was a kid, you know. Although it was a family business where the father let go of a cushy job to run that brand, she's always pushed her what she does as the product. So it's always almost like a tag team. The father would run the business, she would run the product. That girl already at 16 was running shows and was running, you know, her formations, was running how she looks. So you've got to run what you do. Otherwise, someone else is going to run for you. And the day that person gets tired of running for you, what's your plan?